Welcome to eTEN, simple yet powerful. eTEN Smart Learning for CBSE students. Fully 2D 3D animated video lessons. Concept study material to reinforce learning. Download and use offline.
Magnets. Discovery of magnets. Approximately 2600 years ago, in 600 BC, there lived a shepherd named Magnes in Magnesia near Mount Ida in ancient Greece. While herding sheep on the mountain, Magnes found that the nails and buckles of his shoes and the bottom of his stick were attracted to the rock he was standing on. He dug up the earth to find lodestones. People learn to make magnets from piece of iron. Such type of magnets are called artificial magnets. Activity. Take a plastic or a paper cup. Fix it on a stand with the help of a clamp as shown. Place a magnet inside the cup and cover it with a paper so that the magnet is not visible. Attach a thread to a clip made of iron. Fix the other end of the thread at the base of the stand. Mind you, the trick involved here is to keep the length of the thread sufficiently short. Bring the clip near the base of the cup. The clip is raised in air without support like a kite. In the 1830s, the German mathematician and astronomer Carl Friedrich Gauss studied the Earth's magnetic field, which is inside the core of the Earth. Wherever you are on the Earth, the magnetized needle of the compass will always point in the same direction. This occurs because of the Earth's magnet. Earth behaves like a gigantic magnet. Like a magnet, it is surrounded by magnetic field. Magnetic field is the zone where the force is active along the imaginary line, from the south magnetic pole to the north magnetic pole. This force has an effect on all magnetized objects, such as a needle of a compass. If you don't have a compass, you can create your own in much the same way people did hundreds of years ago. To create your own compass, you will need the following materials: a needle, a piece of cork, water, and a dish. The first step is to turn the needle into a magnet. The easiest way to do this is with another magnet. Rub the magnet along the length of the needle, starting from one end of the needle. When you reach the other end of the needle, lift the magnet and start again from where you started. Repeat this process 20 to 30 times with constant speed. Take a dish, preferably a pie plate, 9 to 12 inches in diameter, with about an inch of water in it. Now take something small that floats, such as a piece of cork or a piece of plastic, and put it into a dish filled with water. The cork will float on the surface of water. Once it gets stable, put the needle on top of the cork horizontally. On observation, you will find that the needle will point towards the nearest magnetic pole, north or south, depending upon where you live. Dropping a magnet. If we drop a magnet repeatedly, it becomes weak and may lose its magnetism. Have you heard of trains that do not have wheels? Maglev train, also called magnetic levitation train or maglev, a floating vehicle for land transportation that is supported by either electromagnetic attraction or repulsion. These trains do not have wheels. Isn't it strange? Maglev trains incorporate a basic fact that magnetic forces like magnetic poles repel each other and opposite magnetic poles attract each other to lift, propel and guide a vehicle over a track or guideway. These trains can run to a speed of as high as 600 km per hour.
To explore more content for conceptual clarity, give a missed call on 7043-722-733 and get a link to download now. eTEN, simple yet powerful. To know more, call on 7096-722-733. Act now.